In July of 2019, longtime Boston Globe sports columnist Dan Shaughnessy wrote a piece entitled, "The Red Sox May Be Red Hot, But Baseball Is Striking Out in Every Way." In it, he laments on the state of contemporary baseball and his own frustration in encountering the slow pace of the game in the 21st century. Shaughnessy insists that something must be done to save the game from itself. To quote from the article, "Baseball has become the sanctuary of senior citizens, hardcore baseball fans of the same people who have landlines in their home and still read the daily newspapers. Anybody seen my sporting news? Pace of play has made the game largely unwatchable on television. Tom Verducci recently put his stopwatch to work and calculated that the average time between balls and play is 3 minutes and 45 seconds. This is unacceptable. It is killing the sport. There is simply not enough action." So for Shaughnessy, the game of baseball is falling behind the times, and it must adapt and optimize itself to this new post-Gutenberg world that we now find ourselves living in the 21st century, the world of algorithms and memes and viral videos. And although this critique correctly points out the radical disjuncture between the logic of a game like baseball and the logic that undergirds our globalized, digitally connected society, the problem is that it completely fails to grasp the fact that a whole new sense of temporality has been set off by the digital revolution, and why a sport like baseball, especially a sport like baseball, is not only inherently incompatible with digital-based time, but that baseball could potentially function as a form of resistance to this new horizon of computational-based temporality. In other words, rather than seeing baseball as bravely resistant to being incorporated into the ever-growing planetary system of techno-capitalism, Shaughnessy wants baseball to effectively give up its defining character and discover instead how it can better integrate itself into the global technological machinery. I think that in a very simple and general way, we could say that history has been set in three different temporal periods or epochs. The first we could call the agricultural or indigenous model, the basic temporal model that human beings experienced from the earliest human cultures up to the Enlightenment and the subsequent rise of industrialization between the 17th and 19th centuries. Basically, this is the experience of time as a cosmic rhythm, a passage associated with the seasons, the cycles of the moon, and the annual movement of the sun across the sky. The second model came about with industrialization, the introduction of mechanical clocks, railway tables, and the wide emergence of print media. This temporal model had less to do with the natural rhythms of the biosphere than the mechanical rhythms of the factories and clocks that measured the various movements of the economy and society at large. This model was generally in place, at least in developed Western economies, from the 19th century to the dawn of the digital era at the end of the 20th. Although baseball is undoubtedly a game that is deeply related to the first period of temporality in terms of its underlying action and rules, it is invented here in the second and becomes a national phenomenon, cementing itself as America's game by the middle of the 20th century. The third period of temporality, the period we are all now living through in the present moment, is what we could call the digital period. Paradoxically, we are no longer governed by the rhythm of either the sky above us or the clocks around us. Instead, our sense of time is progressively being structured by the mysterious rhythm of quote-unquote real time, the ambient, ever-present specter of computational time that structures network technologies and all of our various digital devices. And it is here, the period of digital-based temporality, where Shaughnessy makes his critique of baseball and wonders if the game can ever adapt itself to the new rhythm of our computational mediated world. But the reason why Shaughnessy's critique falls short and somehow doesn't make sense is because he does not seem to be entirely conscious of the fact that he and the game of baseball are now being subject to a whole new temporal regime, much different from when he first started covering the game as a journalist in the late 1970s. Baseball emerged and became a popular national game in what we identified as the second period of temporality, the period of industrialization and the standardization of time across the Western world. And it became popular perhaps to remind people of the past and their historic relation to a different temporal order. Baseball, of course, is a timeless game. It is not governed by either mechanical clocks or computational real time. It is rather governed by a natural rhythm. You could even say a cosmic rhythm. And this is what Shaughnessy fails to fully grasp when he asks if baseball can update itself and somehow become more compatible with the unbelievable velocity of our globalized capitalist world. The world that now runs according, not to the cosmic rhythms of a baseball game, but rather the internal temporality of computational logic and power. But baseball ultimately calls for narration rather than pure quantification. It calls for attention paid towards the other as its spectators relax and submit their bodies and minds to the game's rhythmic motion. And this rhythm, of course, is connected to the idea of home, the singularity of place that references our being in the world and our experience of time. When Shaughnessy says, quote, "the pace of play has made the game unwatchable," end quote, one should intervene and ask if it is the game of baseball itself that is unwatchable, or is it the fact that the frantic, manic nature of the digital order has affected our collective consciousness to such a degree that we are now unable to pay careful attention to a game like baseball? That our attention spans have been so fractured that we are no longer able to pay attention and give care to the other. In other words, what Shaughnessy and so many other baseball journalists do not account for is that it is not baseball itself that is unwatchable, but rather our brains that have been made unable to focus on a game such as baseball from the combinatory effect of global capitalism and computational time. The very system that he encourages the game of baseball to further adapt itself to. ¶¶